Welcome back. Welcome back. Are you ready for your weekly dose of encouragement? You know I'm ready, and you know I know you are ready as well. Oh, yes. Happy Mother's Day. Happy blessed Mother's Day. On yesterday, we celebrated our mothers. Yes, with our Mother's Day brunch. And you're seeing pictures now from just highlights of our brunch. But you know what? We are in for a special, special blessing for this week, as we will listen to our Mother's Day tribute for coming to us from last year. But before that, you will hear just a snippet of our praise and worship. And yes, we own no rights to the music as the music is being sung. We own no rights to this music as the music is being sung. You know, mothers out there, you are the joy. You are the strength that is needed in the families today. We have a happy, blessed Mother's Day to all, to all. God bless you. God bless you.
Hallelujah belongs to you.
My God.
And we just repeat it.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
And hallelujah is the highest praise.
Yes.
Oh, yes.
Let's sing my hallelujah.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
And we just repeat it again. Say my hallelujah.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
And we just lift our voice and say, you deserve it.
You deserve it.
And repeat it.
You deserve it. You deserve it. You deserve it.
Sing my hallelujah.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
Yes, my hallelujah.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
Sing my hallelujah.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
Sing my hallelujah.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
Now lift it up and say, you deserve it.
You deserve it.
Praise. Oh, he deserves all the praise. Oh, Father. You deserve all the praise. Glory to your name, Father God. Oh, we give you praise, God. Oh, yes. Amen. You know, that's how we praise Him. That's how we set the atmosphere. Amen. Oh, yes. When we come together, we have to set the atmosphere.
Amen.
Oh, Lord. Amen. You deserve it, Lord God. Oh, Father, what's on here next? Oh, please, thank you, Lord. Oh, Lord.
Hello, welcome back to JOP Evangelistic Outreach Ministry. I'm your facilitator for this afternoon, Evangelist Jared O. Today is a very special day. Our daddy, we're celebrating all of our mothers. Yes, all mothers out there. I'm out in the element this afternoon, out here in a memory garden that we put here in memory of our mother when she transitioned, yet now some 3 years ago. And to God be the glory, to God be the glory. And so I just wanted to share some thoughts and all coming from our heart this afternoon and sharing with those. And to share a little bit of the garden. Yeah, you see them, some flowers here and some flowers back here. There's a pavilion that's right behind me. And then here's our balloon. Happy Mother's Day. Happy Mother's Blessed Day. Yes, happy blessed Mother's Day to all. You will hear a lot of noise and all, you know, just ignore, because as I stated before, everyone is out celebrating in their own respective way. Would you please pause with me for a word of prayer as we begin to move forward? Amen. Amen. Pause for a word of prayer. Most Holy God, our Father, our Lord, and our Savior, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Father God, we come for you right now, God. God, we thank you for all mothers, Lord God. Oh, Father, we thank you for all of our mothers, Lord God. Oh, God, we thank you, Father God, for all our mothers, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Oh, Father, we thank you right now, Lord God, what our mothers mean to us and what our mothers have done for us and what our mothers are yet doing for us, Lord God, relentlessly, over and over and over again. There's nothing like a mother's love. Oh, God, we thank you right now. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen, 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 amen. Oh, yes, you see the hat. Do you like the hat? Mom's hat. Oh, yes, mom's hat as well. I know you can't see it that well, but it is mom's hat. You know, I just have this card I just want to share as well, too. This is a card here, and I just want to share a little bit of the card with you as well. And it says, everyone sees the light and love in your heart. This is to mothers. Everyone sees. And it plays a little song. And it says, thanks for being so beautiful to you. Happy Mother's Day. Happy Mother's Day to all our moms out there. Happy Mother's Day. We are so beautiful. Everyone sees the light and love. That's the light of Jesus. Nothing but the light of Jesus, because Jesus is the light of the world. Mothers are, their mother's heart is so close knit to God as well. We're going to look at the Word of God and the Scriptures. Let's look at Genesis. Coming from Genesis chapter 1, we have to start at the beginning. Yes, we must start at the beginning so that we are encouraged, and yet we remain encouraged too. Genesis chapter 1, at Genesis, and we're going to look here at verse 27. Oh, it's so encouraging. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him. Male and female created he them. And verse 31, and it reads, and God saw everything that he had made, and behold, it was very good. And the evening and the morning were the sixth day, God's creation. When God created us, he looked back and he said that everything that he made, it was very good. Yes, we were made in the image of God. Amen, amen. That's a blessing right there. We were made in the image of God. Amen, amen, amen. God created us. He created male and female. We're going to look at the character, you know, the God's character that he has given, us. He's given mothers. He's given all of us. Amen. Look at Psalms 139. Psalms 139. And this is, everything is flipping, going on out here in the wind, in the air. Psalms 139. You turn there with me. Psalms 139. And we are in fact looking at verse 14. Verse 14. And it says, I will praise thee, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are thy works, and that my soul knoweth right well. We are fearfully and wonderfully made. We must embrace that. It's important to know who we are and whose we are. We were created. We were a part of God's creation, but God created us in His image. And then yet God said in His word that we have been fearfully and wonderfully made. Oh yes, we are fearfully and wonderfully made. And you know, when He created, He knew exactly what He's doing. Oh, happy, blessed Mother's Day. We are fearfully and wonderfully made. You know, all children are a gift from God. Oh, yes, oh, yes, oh, yes. It matters not if one were adopted, if one were just a foster child, if one is in the home. All children are a gift from God. All children are a gift from God, and there's a special mother out there that's attentive and have been attentive and is yet attentive to the children. Oh yes, oh yes, whether it could be a school teacher, it could be anyone, auntie, a grandmother, a mother, there in this, just a friend. But all children are a gift from God. Turn with Mark chapter 9, and we're so encouraged here in Mark chapter 9, looking at verse 36. Mark 9:36, for all children are a gift from God, and we are yet encouraged as we look here again. And here Mark 9, looking at verse 36. And this is here where Jesus is looking, and He's talking with His disciples here. We're looking at, you know, looking at things here. And it says, verse 36, and it says, and He took a child and set him in the midst of them. And when He had taken him in His arms, He said unto him, to them, whosoever shall receive one such children in my name receiveth me. And whosoever shall receive me, receiveth me not, but him that sent me. So there we have it. All children are a gift from God. All children are. That we should receive every child. So if you're a grandmother, if you're an auntie, if you are a mother, if you are a friend, if you are all children, just know that all children, we must receive all children because they are a gift from God. Oh, yes, and we must teach them about Jesus. Yes, we must teach the children about Jesus. That's what He told His disciples they must do. We must teach the children about Him. Amen. He is the Savior. He is our Savior. Amen, amen, amen. But then look too also at Isaiah 54:13. Let's turn there to Isaiah 54:13. And here again, it's talking to be encouraged about our children. Oh, yes, we're going to get to mom too. We're going to talk about our children first. Let's go back here now to Isaiah. And here we are at, here we go, Isaiah. All right. Isaiah 54:13, and it reads, and all thy children shall be taught of the Lord, and great shall be the peace of thy children. All of our children shall be taught of the Lord. All of them, all our children must be taught of the Lord. Amen, amen. And so this is what women, mothers do. All of you blessed mothers out there, happy, happy, blessed Mother's Day to all of you. And we're going to look at also the virtuous woman, Proverbs Proverbs, and let me see that God created us in His image. In His image, He created all creation. He created us in His image. God is saying to us the word of God, and God tells us that all children are a gift from Him. All children are a gift from Him, and He desires and wants us to teach all children about Jesus. About Jesus. We must impart the word into our children. We must impart the word into our children. If you slacked off, just get back up. Get back up. Get your word. Get your word and begin to get busy. Begin to get busy with the children. With the children. The children need Jesus. The children need Jesus. The children need Jesus. We all need Jesus. The children need Jesus as well. Turn with me now. We're going to look at women. We're going to look at women. We're going to look at a virtuous woman and what the word of God is saying, a virtuous woman. These are the attributes that we as mothers so often do. We as mothers do this without even thinking about it. It just becomes so natural. Mothers are so nurturing. Mothers are so caring. Mothers cares for not only her child, but for every child whom her eyes see or her ears hear sounds of cries that comes from a child. A mother's there to encourage. Turn with me now to Proverbs. We're going to there at Proverbs. Proverbs 31. Proverbs 31. And it's a little windy out. Yes, it is a little windy. I'll let Happy Balloon. He's going to be happy, blown away. Hopefully not. Prayerfully not. Proverbs 31. And here, there we are. Proverbs 31. And it reads, starting at verse 10. Who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above rubies. 11. The heart of her husband doth safely trust in her, so that he shall have no need of spoil. 12. She will do him good and not evil all the days of her life. 13. She seeketh wool and flax and worketh willingly with her hands. 14. She is like the merchant's ships. She bringeth her food from afar. Verse 15. She rises while it is yet night and giveth meat to her household and a portion to her maidens. Verse 16, she considereth a field and buyeth it. With the fruit of her hand, she planteth a vineyard. 17, she girdeth her loins with strength and strengthens her arms. 18, she perceiveth that her merchandise is good. Her candle goeth not out by night. She layeth her hands to the spindle, and her hands holdeth the staff. She stretcheth out her hand to the poor. Yea, she reacheth forth her hands to the needy. A mother reaches forth her hand to the needy. 21. She is not afraid of the snow for her household, for all her household are clothed with scarlet. 22. She maketh herself coverings of tapestry. Her clothing is silk and purple. Her husband is known in the gates, and he sitteth among the elders of the land. She maketh fine linen and selleth it, and she delivereth girdles unto the merchant. 25. Strength and honor are her clothing, and she shall rejoice in time to come. She opened her mouth with wisdom, and in her tongue is the law of kindness. Verse 27. She looketh well to the ways of her household, and eateth not the bread of idleness. 28. Her children arise up and call her blessed, her husband also, and he praiseth her. 29. Many daughters have done virtuously, but thou excelleth them all. 30. Favor is deceitful and beauty is vain. But the woman that feareth the Lord, she shall be praised. 31, give her the fruit of her hands, and let her own works praise her in the gates. A virtuous woman. Happy, blessed Mother's Day. Happy, blessed Mother's Day. Verse 26, I'm so encouraged by verse 26. She opens her mouth with wisdom, and her tongue is the law of kindness. A mother opens her mouth with wisdom, and her tongue is the law of kindness. Happy, blessed Mother's Day to all, to all. To God be the glory. In all things we give thanks, in all things we give thanks. Whether a mother is asleep in Jesus, a mother is right here beside you. Your mother may be out of town. Your mother may be in a nursing home. Your mother may be at a relative's home. Take time out to give your mother a call. Take time out to listen to your mom. Take time out to let your mother know how much you really appreciate and love her dearly. All children are a gift from God. All children are a gift from God. Be encouraged, be encouraged. Happy, blessed Mother's Day to all. And here again, this is the garden. Yes, this is the garden. It's actually shaped in the my mother's first initial G. It's actually shaped in the letter G. And it's always filled with some most beautiful, 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 you know, flowers. And it is not quite time as in all not in bloom as yet, but they are, yes, the hat, the hat, the hat. So praise God. So mothers out there, we say happy, blessed Mother's Day to you. You be encouraged. We love you. We love you. We love you. Share the word of God and come back with us again as we yet talking about the word of God with our Bible study inspiration. Just wanted to just take some time out and say happy, blessed Mother's Day again to you all. We love you much. In Jesus' name, amen, amen. And keep on being who you are. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you.